Pick our way in.
As far as it goes here, now this is, of course, a blacksmith shop. This is a place where you'd come to get chains, hooks, hinges, garden tools, just basic tools and hardware. I do not work with 1,000-pound riding lawnmowers. I am not a farrier, I am a blacksmith. Just the same way as I do not work with guns, I am not a gunsmith, nor am I a sword maker. What I am doing today is I'm actually going to make a special order on some hooks. Now, the steel I started out with is mild steel, of course, these days. In the 18th century, of course, it would have been, well, it would have been beautiful iron or steel. Now, of course, what I'm doing is I take a piece of round rod, and I'm going to go ahead and heat that up to about 2,000 degrees. Now, of course, I need to know what the temperature is, but the only way I can tell is by looking at the color. It starts out black. It goes from black to red to an orange to a yellow. But if you turn it white, it will actually be too hot, and it will be a melted mess. Now, of course, this one right now is a nice bright orange to a yellow. It's going to be about 2,000 degrees. Pretty hot, but you notice I'm also holding on to it with my hand. I will bring it over to my anvil here using my beautiful, beautiful 100-year-old hammer on it. And I'm working on something. I'm going to go ahead and work this quickly as I talk. Metal is a fun stuff to work with because you can take it and you can shape it whichever way you want to go, and you just have to keep working it while it's hot. There is an old saying, strike while the iron is hot.
Think of the fire, strike while the iron is hot.
And then we start working in finesse on it. Now we have a good start. Now you can see what I have actually done here. I've flattened it out, gave it almost a little bit of a leaf shape. It is flattened out this way. But what I do need to do, because it turned cold, it's still about 600 degrees, you wouldn't want to touch it. Give me a nasty burn. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to stick it back in the forge here, and we're going to reheat this.
Fire it up.
If you would.
Heat on it.
Please, heat me up nicely. And of course, this is Captain Scarlet J.
Hi.
Also, one of the captains of the Devil's Triangle, I believe. Wait a minute. I'm Captain Wasabi. Yes, I am part of the Devil's Triangles also, as a captain. Now, of course, what I don't know what Captain J is going to be working on yet.
It's worth being captains in our crew, man. Nobody listens to you.
Exactly, especially to me.
Well, of course, especially to you.
Yes, because, yes, we don't want to do that.
That's just because you never stop talking, man.
Well, that's my job, isn't it? It's stealing. If I'm not talking, I'm stealing, aren't I? Are not I the best captain that's pirate there is?
Hey, you over there with the camera. I wouldn't be talking to the captain like that.
I've got to make that last hook.
That camera's starting to look good.
No. Back into the heat. Coming out of the heat. Now we're going to work out the shaft of this.
Are we saying that Captain Wasabi is working his shaft?
Yes. If you hit it hard enough, you can actually take and bring it back into the heat. Always, always about the finesse on things. Get in there slowly. You will get to see this whole project from start to finish. Heat, though. Needing more of. Things cool down, you have to reheat it. There's an old saying, strike while the iron's hot. If you hit it when it's cold, you're going to Hades, number one. Number two, you're gonna hurt yourself, because it will break, and that piece of metal will drive right into your skin. It doesn't feel good. Now, in 7 years as a master blacksmith that I have been, 3 times have I burned myself, so I don't think that's too bad. But, of course, I do make things that are sharp, and I do work with things that are hot. So once in a while, well, you do get cut and burned at the same time. Coming out.
Melting me piece, man.
Well, your piece not be left in the fire.
Man, I know you've seen it.
I'm working. Can I have me tongs, please? Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hot piece of rod.
Yes. Is it done yet?
Now! It will be. almost lost my heat on this one. But I'll work it back into the heat. Back into the fire, she goes. Now that I've got this nice and square, I'm going to round it off. I'm using a hammer and hitting it on the edges and corners of it. You can actually round a piece back off. Get a nice bite on that again. Put a nice little bend in her. Use every piece of the anvil that you absolutely can. As they do cool off quickly. Now what we're using is coal, something that comes out of the ground. And of course, the Spanish would use charcoal, carbón. That's what I prefer to use, but this forest uses coal. Of course, down here, you know, that's what they have. So, at any rate, charcoal, of course, carbon, well, you take iron and you introduce carbon to it, you now have steel. The more carbon you put into it, the harder the steel becomes. So to a certain degree, you actually wind up with a better piece of metal by doing it that way. Now we see this nice and hot. I'm going to go ahead and work with something we call scrolling tongs, so they can actually scroll. Grab it right about in here. Work it back around to itself, like so, and then back this way. We're starting to get the shape that I'm looking for. I'll stick it back in the heat here, let it absorb. Are you done with this?
Yes.
Sticking anything I can to make a tool. Of course, as a blacksmith, if you need a tool, you make it. Very, very simple. Lost one already in there.
Oh, see right there, right? You got your scrolls.
I see that. I'll just go ahead and use this one here because it was here. Come with me, fingers, and start working. Anything I can make for a tool, I will use. I never ever want to reach down and grab one of these. They're pretty hot still.
Not nice when they fall down in your boots, are
well,
they?
Well, no, when they fall in your boot, you do a little bit of a dance. Not a good dance either.
You're done with that?
Yes. I am done with this one. Just about completely done with this one, in fact. Now, the true test, of course, is going to be how well does it look put up against? Not too bad.
Yeah, it's just like the other one.
Pretty close. Actually, a little closer to this one, I believe. But that's the key to making something, is being able to try and make them all pretty much the same.
It looks great, man. Can I have them on tongs
now? No. Throw it into the water. Now you may have the tongs. Right there on there. So wait a minute. Now there's two in here. Well, what happened here? It grew. Look at that. One into two.
Pirate
Pretty
magic.
Pretty close, eh? This is the way it is done. Of course, by Captain Wasabi. And of course, Captain Scarlet Jay.